Welcome to E-Content Development Center, Majlis Arts and Science College, Valancheri. Myself, Najia, Assistant Professor, Department of Microbiology. In this video session, I am discussing about glycolysis, which is the one of the important metabolic pathway that is involved in all living cells. The word glycolysis comes from glycis and lysis. It is the merger of two words from Greek words. Glycis means sweet or sugar, and lysis means splitting or degradation. So glycolysis is the merger of these two words, meaning sugar lysis or sweet lysis. It is also known as EMP pathway or Emberden Meyerhof Parnas pathway. Gustav Emberden, Otto Meyerhof, Jacob Carol Parnas. These were the three scientists who elucidated these steps for glycolysis. Carbohydrate metabolism is the important metabolism involved in all living cells. Among these, glucose is the central molecule, and all the metabolisms involved in the carbohydrates are connected with it. The learning outcome of this topic is you will get the importance of glycolysis and how the energy is produced during glycolysis and how much energy is produced. Glycolysis is the sequence of reactions that is catalyzed by different enzymes. Here, one molecule of glucose is converted into two molecules of pyruvate. It occurs in almost all living cells, and it occurs in the cytosol of the cell. It occurs either by aerobically or anaerobically. In aerobic process, pyruvate is the end product, and in anaerobic process, lactate is the end product, but it does not involve the molecular oxygen. The steps of glycolysis are divided into mainly three phases. First phase, energy investment phase or priming stage. Second, splitting phase. And third, energy generation phase. These are the entire steps involved in glycolysis. Here, one molecule of glucose is converted into two molecules of pyruvate. It contains 10 steps and 10 enzymes are involved in this process. Here, I will give you the stepwise explanation of glycolysis. First, step 1, phosphorylation. Here, glucose is phosphorylated into glucose 6-phosphate by the enzyme hexokinase or glucokinase. Hexokinase has high affinity to the substrate glucose, and glucokinase has low affinity to the substrate. Here, I told you that this phase is coming under energy investment phase. So, energy is required. So, ATP is broken into ADP. So, one molecule of ATP is utilized here. Here, glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate by the enzyme hexokinase or glucokinase. This is the second step of glycolysis, isomerization. Here, glucose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 6-phosphate by the enzyme phosphoglucoisomerase. Some metals like manganese, magnesium, etc. are required for the activation, and it is a reversible process. The third step of glycolysis is again phosphorylation. Here, fructose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6-phosphate by the enzyme phosphofructokinase. Here also, one molecule of ATP is required, and the process is irreversible. So, the first three steps involved in glycolysis are coming under first phase, energy investment phase or priming stage. Then, the second stage of glycolysis is splitting phase. Here, breakdown of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is into two molecules of three carbon-carbon compounds, dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Here, one molecule of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is divided into two molecules of carbon compound, one dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate by the enzyme aldolase. The fifth step of glycolysis is isomerization. Here, dihydroxyacetone phosphate is oxidized into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate by the enzyme phosphotriose isomerase. So, from one molecule of glucose, we will get two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. The sixth step of glycolysis is coming under third phases of the glycolysis, that is energy generation phase. Here, two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is oxidized into two molecules of glyceraldehyde 1,3-bisphosphate. Here, phosphorylation reaction takes place and two molecules of NADH are produced. The enzyme catalyzed by the reaction is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. So, the resultant reaction is like that. Two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is converted into two molecules of glyceraldehyde 1,3-bisphosphate by the enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. Two molecules of NADH are produced. These molecules are enter into the electron transport chain for further energy production. In the seventh step of glycolysis, glyceraldehyde 1,3-bisphosphate is converted into 3-phosphoglycerate by the enzyme phosphoglycerate kinase. This glyceraldehyde 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate is a high energy compound, so it undergoes substrate level phosphorylation to produce one molecule of ATP. In the eighth step of glycolysis, the 3-phosphoglycerate is converted into 2-phosphoglycerate by the enzyme phosphoglycerate mutase. In the ninth step of glycolysis is the dehydration of 2-phosphoglycerate into phosphenol pyruvate. Here, 2-phosphoglycerate is dehydrated into phosphenol pyruvate, which is a high energy compound. The enzyme required for the reaction is enolase, and metals like magnesium is required and water is released. This is the reactions involved in these steps. 2-phosphoglycerate is converted into phosphenol pyruvate by the enzyme enolase. It is the dehydration steps, so water is removed and some metals like magnesium is required. This is the last steps of glycolysis. Here, phosphenol pyruvate is converted into pyruvate by the enzyme pyruvate kinase. The phosphate group present in the phosphenol pyruvate is transferred into ADP, so one molecule of ATP is produced. This is the reactions involved in last step. Phosphenol pyruvate is converted into pyruvate and one molecule of ATP is produced, because this phosphenol pyruvate is a high energy compound, so it undergoes substrate level phosphorylation and produce one molecule of ATP. Here we represent two molecules of ADP is converted to 2 ATP, because two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is undergo this reaction and produce two molecules of pyruvate. This is the end of steps involved in glycolysis. Here, one molecule of glucose is converted into two molecules of pyruvate. First step, glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate by the enzyme hexokinase. Here, one molecule of ATP is required. In the second step, glucose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 6-phosphate by phosphohexoisomerase. Here, isomerization reaction occurs. And in the third step, fructose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate by phosphofructokinase. And first three steps are coming under first stage of the reaction glycolysis, that is coming under energy investment phase or priming stage. Then fourth stage of the glycolysis, that is fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, is converted into two molecules of carbon compounds, one dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate by the enzyme aldolase. Then this dihydroxyacetone phosphate is again converted into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate by enzyme phosphotriose isomerase. This reaction is a reversible process. So we will get from one molecule of glucose, two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate are obtained. Then glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is converted into 1,3 bisphosphoglyceride by glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase, and NADH is produced. Glyceraldehyde 1,3 bisphosphate is converted into 3 phosphoglyceride by phosphoglyceride kinase. Here also one molecule of ATP is produced. Then 3 phosphoglyceride is converted into 2 phosphoglyceride by phosphoglyceride mutase. Then 2 phosphoglyceride is converted into phosphenolpyruvate by enolase, and phosphenolpyruvate is converted into pyruvate by pyruvate kinase, and here also ATP is produced from 1 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. So total we will get 8 ATP from one process. The pyruvate produced from glucose then undergo anaerobic reaction and produce lactate by the enzyme lactate dehydrogenase. Glycolysis is the conversion of glucose into pyruvate, and from one molecule of glucose 8 ATP are produced. So I hope you all of you understood, and thank you for watching. Thank you.